أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وآله وأصحابه ومن اتبعهم إلى يوم الدين وبعد I greet you with the Universal Gift of Islam and that is Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. My dear brothers of Islam who are listening to me today, I'm going to be dealing with the blessing of Allah. As being a Muslim is indeed a blessing of Allah. It is a blessing of Allah because you didn't make yourself and I didn't make myself a Muslim. It is Allah in His wisdom who decided that I'm going to be a Muslim and you're going to be a Muslim. And for that simple fact alone, we should glorify Allah the most and thank Him so very much. When we look around the environment, we see a lot of things happening. And when you consider yourself being a Muslim, you begin to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because the life of every Muslim is surrounded by advice and cautions and warnings and encouragement, as the verse of the Quran is replete with that. And we know the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sent as a mercy for the whole of mankind, where Allah said, "Wama arsalnaka illa rahmatan lil alamin." We did not send you, Muhammad, but as a mercy for the whole of mankind to advise and warn the humanity of the bounties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the hereafter, and also the punishment that actually awaits those who became unbelievers based upon what He gave to mankind. Well, in the background of all these things, here are some pieces of advice that every Muslim, I think, should inculcate in his life to bring them close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala against the backdrop of how the world is moving so very fast in this globalized situation. First of all, I think Bismillah Rahman Rahim should be a point of starter for each and every Muslim in any action that he undertakes. Because if you bring the spiritual aspect of your life in your daily activities, Allah actually becomes your backbone. He cushions you with something that will actually fare you well as you move along in this life, inshallah. So you also learn how to smile where it's necessary. I don't mean you should go smiling everywhere. You open your teeth and smiling this and that. No, it's therapeutic to actually smile to your brother. Don't create that kind of a solid iron fist face and people will complain about it. So a Muslim should always have to, be smiling and be nice, very beautiful countenance. It's a very good advice for each and every one of you, especially me. I think I need this advice so very much. Be humble, be humane, be kind, wallahi. Show compassion and empathy to people around you. May we live in this world once. Once we depart from this world, we're not coming back again. So we might as well leave a very good impression of our life as we leave the air. Deep your hand in your pocket. As a lot of people are called chisel-handed. Don't be like that. Allah, in His wisdom, have made it easy for you. He gave you whatever you want. I mean, He gave you risk. So it's about time that you deep your hand in your pocket and let a poor man smile. At least be merciful for a day. You know, it's very important. It is soothing. It helps your spiritual, upbringing. I know it's difficult, but try as much as possible to have time alone with your Creator. Do some zikr, especially when you are at the bus stop waiting for the bus, in the train station waiting for the train, in the hallway waiting for the doctor to call you in. Send some salam also to the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because spiritually he's going to lift you up and the Messenger is going to smile at you. Be hopeful that everything is in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And know that everything that happens, happens at the right time that Allah have dictated. Nothing happened haphazardly by itself. No. As a Muslim, believe in that. Don't forget to wake up for your Fajr Salah. Because waking up in the Fajr give a little, spiritual aura that comes along and encapsulates you as you begin your day. Allahu Akbar. Try to incorporate the Quran in your daily life. Do not let a day pass without reading the Quran. Listen to the Quran and ponder over the verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let it be as if it's just been revealed unto you and you alone. Now, if you are not good in the Arabic language or the Arabic script like me here, get the English or the French or the German or any vernacular that you can read very well. Reflect upon the verses and let it be as if it has just been revealed unto you. Wallahi, Live a good life. Live a good life, respecting each and every human being. Don't raise yourself. Don't raise your armpit. Don't puff your face. Don't be like, okay, I'm the man. Beside me, there is nobody else. I'm the one in control. I'm the leader. I'm this and that. No, humble yourself. The messenger humbled himself. Humility make people to love you. But if you elevate yourself, Allah will debase you. I'm telling you. Yep. Lest you live along the way in life. Accept what happened to you. That's what Allah have ordained for you. Because nothing happened by itself, like I said, unless it has been, you know, staged by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't pray for yourself alone. Don't be a stingy when it comes to prayers alone. Try to include your family, your parents, your friends. Pray especially for the departed soul, especially the departed parents. Allahu Akbar. For they depend upon you and your prayers as you walk the earth. They can't pray for themselves. They depend upon your prayers. Smile and reflect. May Allah's blessing be upon you and be upon me. Please make dua for me as I make dua for you. And I hope and pray that those, especially who have their children in the western part of the world, teach them how to live Islam. Because now you are acting Islamically. What guarantee do you have that after you depart this world, your children whom you've gave birth in the western part of the world will raise their hand and pray like this? Allahumma rabbi rahamhuma kama rabbayani sagira. Oh Allah, have mercy on me, on my parents, the way they had mercy on me. What guarantee do you have that? So you have to inculcate Islamic teaching to your children. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu qu anfusakum wa ahlikum nar. Oh you who believe, protect yourself and your parents, and your wife and your children and those under you from the hellfire. The only way you could do that is to train them towards Islam. When you come to the masjid on Friday, bring your children. Let them just be playing around. Let them make noise in the masjid. Let them pour some water on the carpet. There's no problem with that. At least let their heart be attached to the masjid. Once you do that, you've given them a legacy that after you, they know this is the place that they should be coming in. May Allah make it easy for you. May Allah make it easy for me. If I make any mistake in my narration, Ya Allah, I ask that you forgive me because I'm only human, created weak. But if I do it right, Allah, I expect, you know, rahmah and mercy, multiply, you know, the blessings for me and for those who are listening to this. Hazza billahi tawfiq. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.